Last month, I said the Hoka Mach 6 was the best daily trainer of 2024 that I've tried, but after 100 miles, how's it holding up? So welcome back to another video, and today I'm giving you guys a 100 mile update on the Hoka Mach 6. This was a really exciting shoe for me to get my hands on, and I'm delighted to have got it to 100 miles so quickly and to share with you my thoughts on the shoe. As with all 100 mile updates, I'll be going through the wear and tear, how I've been using it, and of course will I continue to use it moving forwards, plus a bit of a bonus at the end where I talk a little bit about the comparison between this thing and the Endorphin Speed 4, which is something that I did a video on not too long ago. So if you're excited for today's video, guys, make sure you give it a like, share it with your friends, and of course subscribe to the channel for weekly running content. Let's start with the wear and tear. So let's go through the wear and tear first. This thing is holding up really well at 100 miles. I always say it, but at 100 miles you just don't want to see any degradation anywhere on the shoe realistically. And with Hokas, obviously the midsole is something of a talking point, and I've had shoes at this point with the Hoka, namely the Clifton 9, where the midsole foam just feels absolutely dead. So we'll go through all of that now. In terms of the upper, if you excuse the mud, because that's just the state of the weather here in the UK, it's holding up really well. No snags, no frays, no tears. Everything is looking really darn nice on this shoe. Still really comfortable, and everything is in good working order. The midsole, I am pleased to report, is holding up really well. It still feels as soft, as squishy, as it did when I pulled it out of the box. Now, the reality with this thing is, in terms of performance, that I noticed the midsole opened up a little bit after 3, 4, or 5 runs-ish, and I noticed it got a little bit softer than straight out of the box, and from that point, that's kind of where it stayed. It stayed lovely and soft, but still nice and bouncy. The outsole is showing absolutely no signs of wear whatsoever. It is looking really, really good. There's always a little bit on the very toe area. I find that in all my shoes, but for the thin rubber that they have decided to use on this version of the Mach, it's doing really well. I've run in a multitude of conditions, and it's just grippy, it's working well. The exposed midsole is chewing a tiny bit there, but I mean, that is nothing compared to what we've seen in previous Hokas. So yeah, overall, it's doing really well. So how have I been using the Hoka Mach 6 to get it to 100 miles so quickly? Well, it has taken the bulk of my easy and moderate mileage. When I'm looking at my shoe rotation right now, there's not another shoe that I want to use more than this thing. And that says a lot, because I'm using the Endorphin Speed 4 and a few others, but this thing is often getting the nod over those shoes. So it's taken a lot of my Monday easier miles, which of recent times have been a lot longer. And that has helped with the reason that this thing has got to 100 quite quickly. My medium long runs on a Tuesday at a steady pace. Sometimes my easy runs on a Tuesday evening on that double day. And then often on my Friday steady day too, this thing comes into play. And it is just great. I love it for a couple of reasons. Number one, the midsole is soft and squishy, but not too marshmallowy. It's enough to enjoy and feel like it babies the legs, but not too much where you really feel like you're sinking and trudging to get back out of the foot strike. And that being said, the rocker in this shoe is quite pronounced. I really enjoy it. I actually walked around in this shoe for the first couple of weeks, because it was the only shoe that a few weeks back when I got it wasn't aggravating a little Achilles issue that I had. And when you're walking, you really do notice that this thing puts you on your toes very quickly. So I enjoy that because it means that my foot strike isn't in transition too much. I literally land and I'm rolling through and I'm off straight away. So I get the lovely cush of the midsole, but I don't get too much sinking because I already feel like I'm already on my toes and away into the next cycle. So that's really nice. That's why I love it. It is on the snug side. It is a slightly narrower shoe, but again, with someone with a wider foot, this hasn't bothered me whatsoever. It didn't in the Mach 4. It hasn't in this. I haven't had any blisters, any hot spots, any rubbing. It's been extremely enjoyable. As you can see with this one, I have actually used the extra eyelet. This was due to my Achilles issue that I had a few weeks ago. That's now completely sorted. I didn't need to use it like this. I just did it there so that my heel wasn't slipping up and down in any of my shoes to cause any rubbing or any extra aggravation. And I've just left it like that. But in all honesty, I wouldn't really usually use it like that. In fact, this is probably the first time in 10 years that I've really ever used the extra eyelet. So overall, yeah, it's been absolutely fantastic soaking up so many of those miles. So then that leaves a question. Will I continue to use this shoe moving forwards? The answer is, without a doubt, yes. yes, this thing is going strong. The one thing that has questioned so many times with Hoka is durability. And when we see, obviously they use a lot of EVA foams and they have done in the past. A lot of people think they're quite behind with their midsoles. I kind of agree. I feel like they need to kind of move forward a little bit. They're a couple of years behind when it comes to that sort of thing. But the reality is this supercritical EVA that they're using in this one is really, really comfy. Now, the Mach 4 was the only Hoka shoe that I've ever got over 300 miles in, and that lasted really well. And then it started to go flat. Now, if I'm honest, I know a lot of people like to get 500, 600, 700, 800 miles out of a shoe. That's absolutely fine for someone of me, of my height and my weight, which is around 6'6" and anywhere between 86 to 90 kilos, depending on what part of my training cycle I'm in at the moment. I'm quite happy to get 300 plus out of a lot of shoes. I often find that I'm putting a lot of force through each foot strike, a lot more than some of you out there, which are a lot lighter than me and a lot smaller. So often I can find that 300 is the limit for a lot of shoes, never the Nova Blast. But other than that, I have found that a fair few, not just Hoka, but others get to that point and then they start to die. So if I can get 300 out of this, I'll be extremely happy. I do feel that this is good progress with the midsole. I do feel like this is really enjoyable. I actually prefer it to the Mach 4. I love the Mach 4. But sometimes those dual density things, it works or it doesn't work. I kind of wondered whether it worked in the Mach 4. I enjoyed it a lot, but it was kind of one of those shoes where I only had one of those type of shoes in my rotation at the time. With this one now, I've got a multitude of shoes that I could choose from, but I'm still gravitating towards this. So I do intend fully on continuing using it. However, I do want to now focus on the Endorphin Speed 4 and get that there. And we're going to talk more about that one now. Now, I don't quite have that shoe to hand, but there are a couple of things I just want to highlight with the Speed 4, kind of a follow-on from that video that I did 2 or 3 weeks ago, or whenever it was now. So I stacked these two shoes up against each other and pointed out the similarities of them, and they are very similar. But despite the fact that the Mach 6 is a 5mm drop and the Endorphin Speed is 8, they're 37 and 38mm drop in the heel, so they start at very similar points. And in terms of what they're designed for and the manufacturers have put them out there for, they are kind of bridging that gap between realistically an easy day shoe and a top end racer. They're meant to be slotted in the middle there. And although I haven't probably used the Mach 6 or even the Speed 4 for those workouts or that maybe middle ground, I do find them to be very, very similar when I'm running in them and really for what their purposes are. I do find myself more efficient in the Endorphin Speed 4s. Now that's going to be down to probably the fact that the way the shoe's set up with that speed roll technology. I mean, we've got a rocker in this shoe, which, as I said, puts you on your toes very quickly and gets you moving nicely. The speed roll tech in the Saucony shoe is just a posh way for you to say it's just carved out in a way that is efficient for you. So when you land, you roll through nicely and push off. That coupled with the nylon plate and the Piba base foam probably all give you a little bit more responsiveness than what the Mach 6 does. The Mach 6 is slightly softer, I find, than the Speed 4. And so with the firmer shoe in the Speed 4, I do find that I roll through nicely and glide rather than a little bit more sink in this one. Although I do roll through nicely, you do sort of sink in that squishy foam a little bit. So I do find my heart rate to be lower in the Endorphin Speed 4. I do still prefer the Mach 6 to ride. And I do stand by the fact that I still give that one the crown at the moment. It will obviously come down to durability, and I'd love to be able to push both those shoes to a good mileage. But I just wanted to highlight the fact that after I've now done a few medium long runs in both of these shoes, put a few 90 minute runs in both the shoes, and just in general some longer miles in them, I do find myself to be slightly more efficient in the Speed 4s. So there we go. There's my update on the Hoka Mach 6 after 100 miles. Going strong, feeling good, no different from the start, which is a big positive sign. So my next milestone with this one will of course be 200 miles. Let's see where it gets to, and let's see if it's still feeling as good at that point as it does now. Fingers crossed it does. I'd love to hear it from you guys. Did you pick up this shoe and are you quite surprised by it, or are you not a fan? I'd love to hear how many miles you've got in it and how you're finding this thing is holding up as well. That's it from me today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, of course, please do consider giving it a like, share it with your friends, and please do subscribe to the channel for weekly running content, and I'll see you on the next one.